So in the last class we were looking at S bar and Q bar. So what is this S bar? Any idea? You want me to revise it quickly, the previous class ones, or how is it?
Can you revise it quickly?
Yeah. Okay. So here, if you are considering a 0-degree lamina, okay, if you are considering a 0-degree lamina, the strain and the stress is related by the, what is this matrix?
Compliance matrix.
The stress and the strain are related by, what is this
matrix? Reduced stiffness matrix.
Okay. Then coming to the transformation matrix, the, when do you use transformation matrix?
When there is global stress and strain.
Yeah, when you have the angle lamina, okay? You have the lamina at an angle. That is, fiber is inclined at some other angle. Then the local stresses is related with the global stresses by a transformation matrix. The global stresses and the local stresses are related by a inverse transformation matrix. Coming to the strains, it's the same thing, but only difference is here it is gamma 12 by 2 and gamma xy by 2. Okay. And suppose you don't want to write it as by 2 here, then you use this R into T into R inverse, where R is this matrix. Okay. So any confusion in this? Any confusion in this slide? Okay. So just that you don't want to write it as by 2 over here. So you use this thing to avoid writing by 2 here. Okay. Next is the inverse transformation matrix, the global strains related with the local strains. So it's the same thing, except that there is T inverse over here. Other things are same. Next, what we want to do is we wanted to have a relation between global stresses and global strains when the lamina is inclined. Okay. If this is not inclined, if the angle is equal to 0 degree, what will be this? This whole thing will be just, what will it be? Yeah. If this was a 0 degree lamina, the global stresses and the global strains are related by what? What will be this? This will be a Q.
Reduced stiffness matrix.
Okay. Now, since we are considering an angle lamina, okay, since we are considering an angle lamina, this cannot be just Q. Okay. This cannot be just Q. So it has to be something else. It must be transformed. Okay. So this Q bar is also called as transformed reduced stiffness matrix. Okay. Q is called as a reduced stiffness matrix, whereas Q bar is called as transformed reduced stiffness matrix. Okay. So how did we arrive at this? We said the local strains is equal to the transformation matrix multiplied by the global strains, and this can be written this way. And then we said, instead of the local strains, we write it as local stresses, okay, with a multiplication of the reduced stiffness matrix. So for this whole thing, you multiply with Q, then you can get the local stresses. Now, if you want global stresses, then what you do, you have the inverse transformation matrix multiplied by this whole thing. Okay, so this whole thing is called as Q bar. This is how you arrive at Q bar. Any doubts in this thing? Any doubt in this, please ask. It's very important that you understand this. Any doubt in Q bar derivation? Is any doubts?
No, sir.
Next, we wanted to derive this S bar. What is S bar? The strain stress relation. Okay, the global strains related with the global stresses. So, if this had been a 0 degree lamina, then this would be just S. Okay, since it's an angle lamina we are considering, so this would be a S bar. So how do we get this? We find out the local stresses from the global stresses. This is related by the transformation matrix. Now, once we know the local stresses, we want the local strains. Okay, so for that, what we do, we multiply this whole thing with the compliance matrix. Okay. And once we know the local strains, how to get the global strains? It is the inverse transformation matrix. So when you take the inverse transformation matrix, always remember you have to use this three matrix. Okay, R, T inverse, R inverse. Okay, so it's not just T inverse. Okay, so you have to use R, T inverse, R inverse, and then this whole thing, S, T, and this thing. So this is called as S bar. So what is S bar also called as? Transformed. What is it? Transformed compliance matrix. S bar is called as transformed compliance matrix. Any doubts so far? Any doubts, please ask. Okay, so we'll just we were looking at the MATLAB as well. So are you able to see the MATLAB screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here we defined this S matrix, then we said the reduced stiffness matrix is inverse of this compliance, and then we defined what is C. It is cos d theta, where theta is 60 degree. Okay, and then we defined the transformation matrix, we defined the R matrix, okay, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 2, and S bar, this is what we got from that derivation. We have just put the formula, okay, and then Q bar is inverse of this S bar. Okay, you can also write it like this, where we derived the Q bar. If you are using a percentage symbol before that, that means it is commented. Okay, it will not execute. Okay, those lines which has a percentage symbol in the beginning will not execute. So what are the things that you will get if you execute this program? So everything which is ending with a semicolon will not be seen in the command window. Only the things which is not ending with a semicolon can be seen. So you can see S bar, you can see Q bar, okay? Now I run this program. So you see S bar and Q bar. Okay, so what is the units of this S bar? What is the unit of this S bar matrix? Yeah. I need some interaction, please. What is the unit of this S bar? What is the unit of S matrix?
So 1 by GPA.
Okay. The same thing applies for S bar as well. S and S bar has same units. Okay. And Q bar has units of GPA. Okay. Since we have taken what are the input values we have given here, it is E1 is 181 GPA, E2 is 10.3 GPA, G12 is 7.17 GPA, all those. Okay. So this is what we have defined, and what you get S bar and Q bar is for a particular angle. Okay. It's for a particular angle. What is the angle? It is 60 degrees. Okay, it is 60 degrees. Fine. Any doubt in this program? Have you tried doing this? Did you try calculating S bar and Q bar anytime? Did you try doing this?
Not yet, sir. We'll try that.
Okay. I'll also put this program in the Google Classroom so that you can refer to this. Okay. So what is S matrix? See, S11 is 1 by E1. Okay. S11 is 1 by E1. So what will be S11 bar?
E1.
No, S11 is 1 by E1. What will be S11 bar? It will not be E1. It will be
minus
1 by no, it will be see, this can be written as 1 by EX because the angle is 0. Okay, so this can be written as, if the angle is 0, you can write 1 by E1 as 1 by EX. Okay, but if the angle is not 0, if the angle is 60 degrees, then what will be this one? It will be 1 by EX for an angle of 60 degree lamina. Okay, it will be 1 by EX. Okay, it will be 1 by EX when the angle is 60 degrees. Okay, so can we find out? Did you understand this thing? This is simply S11 will give you 1 by EX, okay? 1 by EX, that is EX at angle 0 degree. 1 by here, if you are looking at S bar, S11 bar will give you the value of 1 by EX at theta equal to 60 degree, okay? Because you have taken theta 60 degree. It will give you 1 by EX. That is, what do you mean by 1 by EX? So if you find EX from that, you can know what is the stiffness along the X direction when theta is 60 degree. Okay. So can we find out for 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, up to 90 degrees. Okay. 0 to 90 degrees in the step of 10 degrees. What is the value of EX? Okay, so suppose I look at S matrix as well. Okay, I want S matrix also to be shown. Okay, so what is the value of EX here? What is the value of EX? Can somebody calculate? We need calculators now. What is the value of EX? Yes.
181.81
GPA. Okay. 181.81 GPA. Now, what is the EX value at theta equal to 60 degree? It will be 1 divided by 0.0805. Okay. It will be 12.42 GPA. Okay, do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what it means is EX is equal to 181.8 GPA when theta equal to 0 degrees. Okay, EX is equal to 12.42 GPA when theta is equal to 60 degrees. What do you understand from this?
It will vary, sir.
Okay. The stiffness of the composite along the x direction, okay, the stiffness of the composite along the x direction is having higher value when theta equal to 0 degree. Why is this? Why is it having higher value? Why is it having a lower value? Why the number is decreasing?
That zero, the stress will be along x axis at 0 degree.
Forget about stress. Okay, you have the fibers along that direction. Okay, the fiber is along the x direction. Okay, the fiber is along that direction. The resistance offered by the material for elastic deformation, okay, in the x direction will be higher. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Because fibers are along that direction. Okay, it's difficult to deform it easily. Okay, but if the fiber is at 60 degree, then the resistance offered by the material, okay, for elastic deformation along the x direction, okay, along the x direction when theta equal to 60 degree is only 12.42 GPA instead of 181.8 GPA. Okay, are you able to understand this? Are you able to understand how I got this value? This is nothing but 1 divided by EX. Okay, same way as how it was for the S matrix. Okay, so from S matrix you get for theta equal to 0 degree, but from S bar you get the EX value for the angle what you have given. Okay, now what we'll do is, what about EY? Where will you find EY? Can you please tell me where will you find EY? This thing gave you 1 by EX. Okay, what will give you 1 by EY? Yeah, I want some answers.
Yes, 22 sir 0.0 9 7.
Yeah, EY. Can somebody calculate and tell me what is the value? 1 divided by 0.0971. Okay, it is
10.29
GPA when theta equal to
90 degree 0 degree.
It's not 90 degree, because you have calculated S matrix when theta equal to 0 degree only. Okay, if this was 90 degree, then EY will be having this value, 181.8 GPA. Do you understand this? Okay, now EY value at theta equal to 60 degree, will it be higher than this or lower than this? 10.29?
Lower. Higher, sir.
It will be
higher, sir.
Higher.
Calculate this. 1 divided by which value will you take?
0.0347.
Okay, it will be 28.8 GPA. Okay, because 60 is close to 90. Okay, so you are getting a higher value because you are measuring the stiffness along y direction. Okay, you are measuring the stiffness along y direction. Okay, so this will be higher compared to this one. Okay, what if theta equal to 90 degree? That we will have to see. You need the matrix here. Whatever you have got is for 60 degrees, so I have taken only 60 degrees. Now let's do it for 0 to 90 with the step of 10 degrees. Okay, with the step of 10 degrees. So how do we do that? Okay, so this is where the MATLAB is going to help. Okay, so instead of saying 60, I'll say theta. Okay, instead of saying 60, I say theta. Okay, then for, I use a for loop for, okay, theta is equal to 0 to with a step of 10 degrees up to 90 degrees. Okay, 0 is to 10 is to 90 means what? From 0 with a step of 10 degrees up to 90 degrees, meaning 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, up to 90. Okay, calculate C is equal to cos d theta, S is equal to sin d theta, then find the transformation matrix for this. Okay, and then calculate S bar. Okay, I want all this to be done, and I don't want Q bar. I'm not taking any value for now. I'll comment it. Okay, and then I'll end the for loop. Put end, the for loop will end. Okay, so what you have used this for loop for? You want theta to be varying, okay, from 0 to 90 degrees with a step of 10. Okay, and you want to calculate all these things. You want to calculate S bar for 0 degree, 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree, and so on till 90 degree. Okay, now if you execute this, what you get is S bar values. Okay, S bar values for, what is this one? The first one?
0 degree.
0. Next is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and so on. Okay, up to 90. Now, what I want you to do is, I want you to calculate EX. I want you to calculate EX and EY, not EY, sorry, GXY. Okay, I want you to calculate EX and GXY for all values of, for values of 0 degree, 10 degree, 20, so on up to 90 degrees. I want you to do this now. Okay, you have all the S bar matrix. Okay, so will this be difficult to do now? Are you ready to do this calculation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that we can have a plot. Okay, so that we can have a plot finally with all those values. So now I'll just show you the EX value. So the first one is 181.8, we have already calculated. What is GXY? You have to take this one, okay? 1 divided by 0.1395, it is 7.168 or something, okay? gxy. Similarly, calculate ex for this and gxy for this. Okay, this is for 10 degrees. What is the angle here? 10 degrees. Okay, this matrix is giving for 10 degrees. Do for 3 matrix. I'll help you with the other values. Okay, we'll do for this 10 degree first. 10 degree is the second matrix here.
Sir, actually that's 0 degree.
The first one is 0 degree. First one is 0 degree. Second matrix is 10 degree.
Second one is S bar, no sir.
Yeah, S means 0 degree. S bar means?
We are varying from 0.
Okay, this is varying from 0. Sorry, I'm sorry. So this is 0 degrees, correct? True. Okay, we are varying from 0. So this is 10 degree. You're correct. You're right. So can you please calculate this EX and GXY for this one? How much do you get EX for 10 degrees? You have to take this value. How much do you get?
Not 7.
107.5 GPA. Okay. And GXY is?
7.38.
7.38. Okay. So like this, you have to calculate for all the values up to 90 degrees. Okay. So now for now, I'll give you the readings, but did you understand how to calculate this? Okay. So what we'll do now is we will plot for 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. Okay. This is x-axis. Okay. Next is y-axis. You need to plot. You're plotting EX values. Okay. EX values. I have calculated it already. I'll just put that. This is 181.8. Okay. And then this is 107.52. This is 50.76, then 28.81, okay, 19.417, then 14.83, then 12.42, then it is 11.12, then it is 10.49, then 10.298. Then it is, this is for the, what are these values?
EX.
Okay. Now you run this code. Okay. You get a plot of how EX varies with the angle, which is the angle here?
X-axis.
Okay. So 181.8 GPA. Okay. From there, the value is going down when you change the angle of the lamina. Okay. So this is the stiffness along the X direction. Okay. Stiffness along the X direction. When you change the angle of the lamina. Okay, what do you mean by changing the angle of lamina? the fiber orientations. Okay, you are rotating the lamina. Okay, so that the fiber is not along the 0 degree, it is along some other angle. Okay, so does this have logic? Does this make sense that at 0 degrees the stiffness is higher? Okay, and when you change the angle the stiffness becomes less along the x direction. Okay, does this make sense? Are you able to understand this? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what we'll do is we will plot another figure. Okay, figure 2, plot. I want you to look at the gxy values as well. Okay, how will the ey values be? How will the ey values look like?
It will be increasing.
It will be reverse of what you saw in ex. Okay, it will be just the reverse of mirror image of what you saw in ex. Okay, so let's not do ey, let's do gxy. Okay, let's do gxy. I've calculated the gxy values. I'll just put those, feed in those values. Okay, what is the gxy value for 10 degree? Calculated 7.38, correct? 8.76, 9.37, 9.37, and then 9.37, 8.76, 7.96, then it is 7.38, then 7.168. Okay, so I close this and then run this. Valid expression. Okay, I close this thing here, run this. So you must be able to see how gxy varies. Okay, you see some horizontal here. Okay, you see some horizontal here between 40 and 50, right? Why is it horizontal? Okay, we are interested to know what is happening there. Okay, so are you able to see this figure? Some interactions, please.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now what we'll do is we'll have a 45 in between. Okay, because we are interested in this region, we'll have a data of what is 45 as well. I've calculated that, so I'll feed in that value. This is 0, this is 10, 20, 30, 40, and after this should come 45. Okay, if you calculate for 45, it is 9.46. okay, now I run this again. What I see here now in the plot is what? What do you see here?
So there is a maximum point and then it starts decreasing.
Okay, what is the angle here?
45 degrees.
45 degrees. You're getting the maximum value for what?
Gxy.
Okay, so what is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of that? What is
up to 45 degrees gxy will increase, sir?
The shear modulus is maximum when theta equal to 45 degree. Okay, so this should give you an idea of why we are rotating the lamina. Okay, if you want your material to withstand the maximum shear strength, okay, so what you should do,
be less than.
What you should do?
You should have 45 degrees.
You should have the lamina at 45 degrees. Okay. If you want to withstand the stress at x direction, axial stress, then what you should do? Axial stress along the x direction. What you should do? You should align fibers along the 0 degree. Okay. If you want the material to withstand the shear strength maximum, then your lamina must be aligned at 45 degree. This is what these two graphs are telling you. Okay. If you plot for EY, it will be reverse. Okay. At 90 degree, you will get the maximum and minimum at 0 degree. Okay. Reverse of this. Just take the mirror image of this. That is your EY. That's why I didn't plot EY. If you want to plot, you can plot it. But I am more interested in this thing. Okay. See, at 45 degree, you are getting the highest shear modulus. Okay. GXY. Okay. So what it means is when your fiber is rotated along the 45 degree angle, then you get the highest shear modulus. Higher shear modulus means what? Higher resistance to shear deformation. Okay. So it'll resist the shear loads. Okay. So there are different applications. There are different complex loads possible. So that is why whenever we prepare a laminate, we don't orient it along one particular direction. We have orientations in different directions, 0, 45, 90, and so on. Okay. So this is the reason why we need to orient the lamina when we are preparing a laminate. Okay. So do you think this value is less? At 0 degree, it is 7.17 around, and this is 9.46. Is the difference huge or less? I'm talking in terms of GPA. Okay. This is 7.17 GPA, whereas this is 9.46 GPA. Okay. So what do you think?
Huge, sir.
Huge.
Okay. It's not just the difference of two. Okay. It's in terms of GPA. So it's huge. So this is what you need to understand when you're studying macro mechanics and why you need to orient the fibers along some particular direction for some particular application. Okay. So the shear strength is higher in 45 degree, whereas the axial direction, it's stronger along the 0 degrees. Okay. So if you are loading in that direction, okay. So the stiffness along the fibers is always in that direction is always higher, whereas it keeps reducing when the angle increases. But the shear modulus is not like that. It increases, it is maximum at 45 degree, and then again it reduces. Okay. So this is something you need to understand, and this forms the foundation for the laminate study. Okay. This forms the foundation for the composite laminates. Why we need to orient the lamina? Okay. Why we need to orient laminas along some particular angles when we prepare a laminate? So these are the things which you need to look at. Any questions? Any questions? Are you able to understand these things? Yeah. Hello. Not audible. Hello. Are you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Okay then. Thank you. We'll have a class tomorrow. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.